Ugh. I could just fast travel somewhere and summon it to me, but I'm just gonna get in the freaking thing and extract, which is what, one? Yeah. Well, that was fun. Glad to be done on Vold again.
Welcome back.
Oh, thank you, Kitty.
Pathfinder, you have new email.
Good, because I'm in front of the email terminal. Complete, yeah. The Asari Ark, to writer from Korra. Had a breakthrough on the location of the Asari Ark. Please come talk to me on the Tempest ASAP. Can you tell me ASAP? Alright, so... I'm not gonna look around for crew update again, I'm just gonna try to find... Actually, the other thing I want to do is these missions. This will like for an hour, so I'm sure they're done by now. I wonder if these ever run out. Waiting debrief. Eliminating supply ships. Successful. I accept the success. Oh wait, that's... The other one's not done? Oh, in progress. Oh, so you can join in progress, meaning. So this, that's right, the Apex one was a lot longer. Alright, so I can choose one more. Ten hours. Hmm, 70%? Locate and remove comm taps? It's another 70%. I mean, I could, it's failed with the odds. Saboteurs we chose not to do. Establish a supply depot. Oh my god, 11%. I wish you could just see the percent right there. 78%. Protect the outpost. Comm taps. This one... I'm gonna take this. Comm taps. Enemy operatives planted taps to monitor a number of our comms. We need a team to find and remove those devices. Oh, wish me luck. Required 1 hour and 8 minutes. Alright, where's Korra? Gil. Oh, once we go to galaxy map. Okay, she's down there. I can't jump. Gotta jump from the railing. Boop.
We got it, Ryder. You patched up the Asari flight recorder?
Oh yeah?
Some old access codes, a little data recovery from Sam. We have the Asari Ark's last heading.
Sweet.
Nav points are set. We can head there whenever you're ready.
You sure about where to go?
That flight recorder was a mess. Are these nav points solid? Worst case, we get a little closer. I'll take a good chance over no chance.
Get a little closer.
We need the Asari and Sarissa more than ever. I trust you to find them before the Kett do.
Okay. At least you trust me. I don't know if I trust me. Search the Valay system. The Valay system. How's that? System. Well, Let's search the Valay system. Sorry about that. Anything else to say?
Ryder? How's the search for the Asari Ark going? Those nav points are set. I'm ready if you are.
Okay.
See you later, Cora. I'll be here.
A note. Okay. This primitive vertical functioning device. Oh. I forgot where I was for a second. I thought it was coming up by the bridge. I'm like, where the hell am I? The Valay system. I guess I'll just head there now.
Vold orbit is steady.
We got new systems. Well, oh, Ramav, I want not to go yet because that's the main quest. Not doing that yet either. So we've been to most of these systems. Not doing that yet either. I guess I had boom. Yeah, I was thinking about cutting it off here, but it's not going to make a good transition, and technical stuff. Let's head to Hefena system, then Vaalon, then Valay. And of course, I'll check out all these systems, read the planet descriptions and all that fun stuff, look for minerals, what have you. It's actually one of my favorite parts of the game, believe it or not.
This might have been a larger system once. Before the scourge.
Really?
As if we needed a better reason to document everything.
A bigger system.
Anomaly detected.
Okay. Before I do anomalies, I'm gonna check out the planets. This one here. Dovar. Because it's the planet on the outer edge of the systems, it's Dovar away. Don't mind me, guys. The Scourge is reaching out for this one. It's a barren rock. Dovar's gravity is abnormally light for a world of its size. This is certainly an effect of mass fields generated by the Scourge. Dovar should be further observed as it escapes Scourge tendrils. Okay.
I'm picking up something.
Kamiru, no. Kamiru, no. Bad girl.
Anomaly on sensors.
Oh, there's an anomaly here. Running out of space. Okay, here we go. Oh, it's in the belt. Okay.
Deploying probe. Getting a scan.
Asteroid. M-type asteroid, diameter 244 kilometers, surface gravity 0.01 g's. Before the Scourge, the asteroid's ringing Camaro No, or a moon housing a small Angaran colony. The moon and the colony are now long gone. Huh. Whose colony? The Angarans? Got some XP from it. And check out the planet. Kamiru No was named for the little brother of mythical Angaran hero Jaylee No. Before the Scourge, Kamiru No existed in the shadow of a much larger gas giant. Oh, there's our answer. losing Karen.
Anomaly on sensors.
Getting to it. One more planet. Was it past 39? Past 39 appears to be the dying remains of Jali No, a massive gas giant named for a mythical Angaran hero. It has been largely stripped of its atmosphere. For a gas giant, it looks pretty solid to me. That's a solid part left of the gas giant? Well, the solid part was maybe separated out or something?
Deploying probe. Getting a scan.
Comet Tallulah. Is this something we were looking for? I know we're tracking, like, several things. A pregnant woman? Cool. Yeah, I think she's going to be there. Data. Nucleus 6.7 kilometers true. Coma cloud 35,000 kilometers. Current tail 765,000 kilometers. Highly reliable orbit despite the scourge and the black hole. We got 40 vanadium. Which I haven't had to use vanadium for anything. Well, it looks like the rocks are just coming out of the base of the comet. So that's it for the Hefena system. Done. 100%. Now, Vaalon. See you later, comet dude.
Like we're coming up on a blue giant.
From Ia, sweet. It's often the brightest star, the first to rise.
That's pretty cool. Pretty cool looking. We got a whole bunch of planets. Look at these elliptical orbits too. Wow. Well, we'll check out. I guess this is the farthest planet. Ramorandi. I guess it depends on what time you're looking at where things are on the orbit, whether they're the farthest planet or not. Heading very close to the scourge here. Oh, there's that's a moon that far away? Oh, that's the other planet, isn't it? The other Ra, yeah.
Anomaly detected.
Oh, goody. Ra Morandi, like Ra Medesia, was thrown out of orbit by the Scourge. Its enormous mass may have pulled in dust and debris to form rings only recently. Homing in on anomaly. Getting a visual.
Deploying probe. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Cool. A Q-type asteroid. It's from the Q continuum. Diameter is 559 kilometers. Surface gravity 0.03 g. This large asteroid may have been a fragment of a moon that once orbited Ra Morandi, somehow broken apart by the Scourge. We got some iron. 75 to be precise. Nothing else to be found, right? Okay. Ra Medesia. So these planets, I guess, going to be torn apart eventually? See what flashes like that, the description then goes away? Ramadesiat and its neighbor, Ramarundi, were both thrown out of their orbits by the Scourge. Even before this, however, Ramadesiat was likely a molten sphere of iron and copper. Nothing to be found here. Okay, so we'll go to Ejoda. Get away from that creepy Scourge. Creeps me out, man. Ejoda is a world of rock and metal surrounded by a crushing atmosphere. By all logic, it should be molten, but the Scourge has somehow kept it cool, despite its proximity to Vaalon's blue giant sun. Okay. Paz 78. What's the Paz designation stand for? Probably stands for something which is also in Ngaran. Oh, cool. This one's cool looking. Look at that. It's the vast eye of the cosmos. Oh, look at that. Freaky! The Eye of Doom, Sauron! Paz 78 is a large gas giant ideal for helium-3 mining. Only the dense Scourge activity in the system makes it a less than perfect refueling point. I've got the Dark Eye on that side. The Dark Eye. I am there. One more. I think. Pass it. There's one, two. Yeah, five. We're missing one? We're missing one. That's that. Oh, Ejoda. I can't even see it. Yeah, we've been there already. Pause 70. My rule is I don't skip the first time we voyage between planets. On repeat visits, I will. And have. It was once they patched that in that we could skip it. I guess they figured everyone just wanted to see it every time, I don't know. Paz 70 appears to be a Catonian planet, a former gas giant stripped of its atmosphere down to its metallic core. It's extremely likely this process was accelerated by the Scourge. I'm seeing more and more planets affected by the Scourge. So that's kind of my hypothesis with the other gas giant that turned into a smaller, solid world. Like, that's the core. All the gas was stripped away. So there's no anomalies on sensors. So we'll leave. And our final destination, at least for now. Really want to head to Hvarl. Finally, at least get that started.
Not many signals out here. Even that random radio noise we get from the Scourge is quieter. Eerie.
Yeah, we're quite remote at this point.
Anomaly detected.
Okay. Let's check out the planets first. Masid. Funny how they look so small till you get right up to them.
Anomaly detected.
Platinum and cobalt form the outer layer of Masid's surface, pitted and cracked by innumerable meteor strikes. Alright, we got anomaly.
Oop. Probes launched. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Cool. Aluminum. A valuable light metal. This deposit is close to the surface and relatively easy to mine. 93 of it. Nothing else, right? Nope.
Anomaly on sensors.
Saving that for last. Pause 16. More and more wondering about this pause. Pause 16 travels in a synchronous orbit around its sun, leaving one side always lit and the other always dark. The reason for this is unclear, but a thread of scourge within its path is suspect.
Anomaly detected.
Forstan detected. Cool. Forstan is largely barren, but its atmosphere is theoretically capable of producing rainfall. Powerful localized storms could appear as often as 3 or 4 times a year. Bloop. Nope.
Deploying probe.
Did I miss it? I missed it.
Probe away.
I moved the mouse.
I found something.
I found something. We found rainfall. Composition, liquid water. Length, 2285 kilometers. A violent and recent rainstorm must have occurred to create this river. The water will be absorbed or evaporated soon. We're supposed to get water? Oh. That helped us reach level 41. Thank God for water. 270 XP. Cry me a river.
Anomaly on sensors.
So it's rainfall that became a river, I guess. Hepal, last planet, innermost planet. Hippal. Much of Hippal's molten surface solidifies during the northern and southern hemispheres' short winters, reshaping the landscape every year. Okay. Funny how it says 100% when we haven't checked out the anomaly yet.
Probe away.
Now it's 100%.
This is Kor's nav point?
Cool. Arc Leusinia. Do you wish to embark on a mission? Okay. Yeah, I'll keep Kor and Liam.
We're approaching the nav points Kor found. Something's there. It might be an arc, but the damn scourge isn't helping.
Sam, help out with the sensors.
Hard to believe the Leusinia could survive in all this.
Let's try to stay positive.
Focus on how we can help them.
Good call. Help Asari, piss off the cat. Very cathartic. Sarissa will have plans for those decimation hunters. Wrote the manual on crisis situations.
The commando you mentioned, you still believe she'll save the day?
Sarissa was a legend even before she was the Pathfinder's bodyguard. She'll have a plan.
Aha! Detecting an initiative vessel.
Reading life signs. And minimal power. Multiple hull breaches. She's a wreck.
But she's intact.
If she's space-worthy and her crew's alive, that's all we need. Callow, take us in.
I'll try. Must be one docking bay still holding together.
Cool. Love the lettering. And here we are. Can't save. Priority mission.
We're aboard. Any response to comms?
Nothing. Maybe their sensors are busted.
Be ready for anything.
What a mess. No space battle did this. They had borders.
Hello? Anyone? We're here to help!
We should bring more rescue gear.
Debris. Internal standard truss. Interior integrity 41%. Salvageable? Tagged for engineering crew. This debris appears to have collapsed during an interior firefight. Ditto. Check if anything's up there before we head to our objective, right?
It's locked down.
No, it's out of power.
Same difference. Either way, we can't get in there.
Beginning decompression. Oh. Die, you Ket monsters.
What?
We're not Ket! We're a Pathfinder team!
Ryder, Lieutenant Harper, and Sam, just send our ID codes.
Confirmed. Sorry. I'm Captain Atandra, of what's left of the Leusinia. Come up to the bridge. Maybe you can help fix this mess.
That was alarming.
Okay, I'd be tense too, but that was close.
I'm keeping my weapon out. Except for when I'm scanning. Navigational holo display. Secondary navigational console error. Error reported. Imminent display failure due to power constraints. Error reported. Data type not recognized. This navigation console is displaying nav data that does not match the initiative standard charting. Source unknown. What's going on here, huh? Same as the other truss, or part of truss.
This area saw combat action. No bodies, though.
No kidding.
Whatever happened left the captain a little trigger happy.
If the Tempest looked like this, how would you feel?
Disappointed. Well, a little upset. Data pad. Leusinia crew complement. Bridge crew, 2 out of 7. Maintenance crew, well, these are all down. Formerly 20, formerly 15 of security team. Medical team, formerly 17. Engineering team, formerly 12. So we've got 2 people alive on this thing. Caution, key systems critically understaffed. Advise against civilian stasis revival. Advise immediate revival of vital personnel. Override authorization number 2443, Theris S. Comment, families first, Sam. Override confirmation number 2443, Sam, Leusinia. Comment immediately, Pathfinder. It's her talking with Sam? Cyrus? Another truss? Another data pad too. Come on. Thank you. Anything else to see? I'll check out that data pad. Status report, Leusinia. Power distribution efficiency 9%. Drive core offline. Life support function 83%. Critical damage report, deck 12. Compartments 3-4 and 3-8B, maintenance compartment 88, and hull impacts on panels 22, 46 through 69, 80, and 98. Yeah, they're pretty screwed up. That is my technical analysis there. Look, they even dropped the plant. Insult to injury, man. What's this? I'm supposed to look at this? Banner. Oh. That's what that is? I'm like, what the hell is this? Some huge tongue? Ceremonial banner. Material. Protein fiber fabric. Smoke particle analysis newly replaced. Records indicate these banners were presented to the Leusinia at her departure by the Atamna Palatea, a group of high priestesses from across the Asari Republics. Okay. Now we got two of them. Still on a guard because of this. We've got cover over here if we need it.
But you'd vent a Pathfinder team into space?
I put my gun away.
Respectfully, yes. We can't take any more chances.
Cirissa Theris, Pathfinder. Don't mind the captain. Scolding me eases her blood pressure.
Sorry, Pathfinder. Well, Cora's your biggest fan.
Cora here thought the famous Cirissa would have everything in hand.
I thought Matriarch Ashara was Pathfinder, ma'am, and you were her bodyguard, like her Tiamna. I served with Asari Commandos, ma'am, memorized all your battle manuals.
Matriarch Ashara is dead. Cirissa was next in line. Her battle manuals haven't kept the cat off my arc.
Hmm. We're here to save you.
That ends today. We'll see your arc safely back to the Nexus.
I hope so. We've tried everything else.
Matriarch Ashara died trying to negotiate with those Ket bastards, so I took something precious from them, too.
Oh?
I stole a module containing tactical data, all their secret routes through this phenomenon.
Hmm.
We call it the Scourge, ma'am. If we could outmaneuver the Ket through it...
we'd stand a better chance against them.
Their Archon had the same thought. He sent his elite agent, the Valiant, and his decimation hunters after us. We take more damage each time we escape the Valiant. The last assault? He sent forces to board us. Cirissa's theft has made things problematic.
Wait, there are Ket on board?
How many boarders are we talking about?
We're not sure, but for now, they're contained down there. We couldn't do more. We spent our resources evacuating civilians. The Valiant wants Cirissa to pay.
She did her job.
Pathfinders have to take risks, Captain. I've taken my share.
Goddess preserve me.
What would it take to get the Ark out of here before this Valiant catches up again?
An FTL burn long enough to lose him. But since the evacuation, we've been stuck at minimal power. The drive core is dead.
My people are investigating, but those systems are below deck, with the Ket borders.
Another Pathfinder team could back them up.
Get power for the drive core, and my Sam and I will finish deciphering the Ket data. Mm. We'll turn the Valiant's escape routes against him.
Consider it done, ma'am.
The last commando report came from Hangar Control. I'll give you access. Please be careful.
Give it our best shot. So they're all called Sam. I thought mine was Sam and the others had different names. Okay, we're just automatically on the tram. Got it. So before I do anything, how many points do I have? So I can get a 30% biotic damage bonus, or plus 15% for weapon damage bonus, melee damage bonus, and melee force. I'll take with the biotic damage bonus. Mm. Now, I'm not going to bother with Cora. And I shouldn't bother with Liam either. I can't until I do their loyalty missions. I only got one place to go.
Okay,
then.
Okay, Cora. Pathfinders take risks. They really do. Matriarch Ashara, your father. We roll the dice, and
now me.
Hey, sometimes we win. Come on. The sooner we find those commandos, the better.